Welcome to this edition of the 411 Talk Song Radio Show. My name is Leon Jones. Tonight, I'm going to continue my Black History Month series. I'm going to talk about Mr. Lonnie G. Johnson. That's right. His name is Lonnie G. Johnson. And basically, Lonnie G. Johnson was an inventor. He was born in 1949 in Alabama. He earned his master's degree in nuclear engineering from Tuskegee University. And he also worked for the Air Force and the NASA space program. Now, after tinkering with the invention of a high-powered water gun, Johnson's Super Soaker became a top seller by the early 1990s. He's since been developing the Johnson Thermoelectric Energy Converter, known as JTEC. That's an engine that converts heat directly into electricity. Now, his father was a World War II veteran who worked as a civilian driver at nearby Air Force bases, while his mother worked in a laundry and as a nurse's aide. During the summers, both of the Johnson's parents also picked cotton on his grandfather's farm. Out of both interest and economic necessity, Johnson's father was a skilled handyman who taught his children to build their own toys. When Johnson was still a small boy, he and his dad built a pressurized chinaberry shooter out of bamboo shoots. It's bamboo shoots. Now, at the age of 13, Johnson attached a lawnmower engine to a go-kart he built from junkyard scraps and raced it along the highway until the police pulled him over. Johnson dreamed of becoming a famous inventor and during his teenage years began to grow more curious about the way things worked and more ambitious in his experimentation. Now, sometimes to the detriment of his family, Lonnie tore up his sister's baby doll, which made the eyes close. His mother later recalled another time. He burned the house down when he attempted to cook up rocket fuel in one of his mother's saucepans, and the concoction exploded. Growing up in Mobile in the days of legal segregation, Johnson attended Williamson High School, an all-black facility where, despite his precocious intelligence and creativity, he was told not to aspire beyond a career as a technician. However, nevertheless, inspired by the story of a famed African-American inventor, George Washington Carver, Johnson persevered in his dream of becoming an inventor. Nicknamed the professor by his high school buddies, Johnson represented his high school at a 1968 science fair sponsored by the Junior Engineering Technical Society, known as JETS. The fair took place at the University of Alabama at Tuscaloosa, as the Crimson Tides, where just 5 years later, Governor George Wallace had tried to prevent two black students from enrolling at the school by standing at the doorway of the auditorium. The only black student in the competition, Johnson debuted a compressed air-powered robot called the Lennox that he had painstakingly built from junkyard scraps over a course of a year. Much of the chagrin of the university officials, Johnson won first prize. Now, the only thing anybody from the university said to him during the entire competition was, Johnson later recalled, was goodbye. You all have a safe drive. After graduating with Williamson's last segregated class in 1969, Johnson attended Tuskegee University on a scholarship. He earned a bachelor's degree in mechanical engineering in 1973, and then 2 years later, he earned a master's degree in nuclear engineering from the school. Now, Mr. Johnson went to join the Air Force, becoming an important member of the government scientific establishment. He was assigned to the Strategic Air Command, which he helped develop the stealth bomber program. Johnson moved on to NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory in 1979, working as a systems engineer for the Galileo mission to Jupiter and the Cassini mission to Saturn before returning to the Air Force in 1982. Now, despite his busy days, Johnson continued to pursue his own inventions in his spare time. One of his longtime pet projects was an environmental friendly heat pump that he used instead of Freon. Johnson finally completed a prototype one night in 1982 and decided to test it in the bathroom. He aimed the nozzle into his bathtub, pulled a lever, and blasted a powerful stream of water straight into the tube. Johnson's instantaneous and instinctive reaction, since shared by millions of kids around the world, was pure delight. Now, this was the power shooter that the kids were buying in the early 1990s. So going back into 1989, after 7 years of tinkering and tireless sales pitching, during which he had just left the Air Force to go into business for himself, Johnson finally sold his device to Laramie Corporation. The power drencher initially failed to make much of a commercial impact, but after additional marketing efforts and a name change, the Super Soaker became a massively successful item. It topped $200 million in sales in 1991 and went on to annually rank among the world's top 20 selling best toys. That's right, the top 20 best selling toys. Also propelled by the success of the Super Soaker, Lonnie Johnson founded Johnson Research and Development and went on to acquire dozens of patents. Some of his inventions included a ceramic battery, hair rolls that set without heat, achieved commercial success. That's right, Dan. Remember this. We know Johnson for the Super Soaker, and everybody's heard of it. But going back to what I just said, some of his other inventions included a ceramic battery and hair rollers that set without heat. They also achieved commercial success. Others, including a diaper that plays a nursery rhyme when soiled. Now, he tried that out, but it didn't catch on. Another invention sought to address the matters of far greater importance with the creation of the Johnson Thermoelectric Energy Converter, known as the JTEC. The engineer aimed to develop an advanced heat engine that could convert solar energy into electricity with twice the efficiency of the existing methods. He believed a successful version of the JTEC had the potential to make solar power competitive with coal, fulfilling the dream of efficient, renewable solar energy. Now, his pitches initially spurred, but Johnson eventually obtained much needed funding from the Air Force in order to continue working on his project. In 2008, Johnson received the Breakthrough Award from Popular Mechanics for the invention of the JTEC. More recently, he had been working with the Palo Alto Research Center, PARC, in California for further development. Since leaving the Air Force, Lonnie G. Johnson has been one of a rare breed of scientists that independent inventor he was, working outside the scientific establishment. He had retired upon patenting the Super Soaker. Johnson would still go down as one of the most successful inventors and entrepreneurs of his generation. However, if he manages to perfect the JTEC, Johnson will carve out a much greater place in history as one of the seminal figures of the ongoing green technology revolution. Paul Warbus of the National Science Foundation summed up the immense importance of Johnson's work. This is a whole new family of technology. It's like discovering a new continent. You don't know what's there, but you're sure you want to explore to find out. It's a darn good chance of being the best thing on Earth. Now, along with the groundbreaking scientific work and inventions, Johnson is board chairman of the Georgia Alliance for Children and a member of the 100 Black Men of Atlanta, an organization that mentors high school and college students. In 2011, he was inducted into the State of Alabama Engineering Hall of Fame. In 2013, Johnson received $73 million settlement from Hasbro, Inc. Yes, he received a $73 million settlement from Hasbro, Incorporated, which had acquired Laramie Corporation a decade later. The inventor had been seeking additional royalty payments from 2007 through 2012. Johnson and his wife, Linda Moore, had four children. They live in Ainslie Park neighborhood of Atlanta, Georgia. Now, let me go on and definitely have you comment on Mr. Johnson. If you read about Mr. Johnson, most of us do know about the Super Soaker. It was a big selling toy. I remember seeing it in the early 1990s. But looking at all of his other inventions, the hair curlers, that's right. I remember seeing hair curlers without heat. That was on one of these infomercials. And see, again, black people have played an immense level of professionalism with their inventions in the world today. Now, again, I'm always going to ask this question, why didn't he get the credit? Now, to Johnson, unlike the first black inventors that I had talked about, Benjamin Banneker and Mr. Lattimore, he's still living. He's still working on the JTEC. Yes, he had to go through some segregation as well. He's about, should be about 67. He's 9 years younger than my dad. But he's got an opportunity to really, if he ever gets that JTEC off the ground, become very synonymous as a black scientist. And, you know, I love doing science and engineering videos because as an African-American, I can tell you, I was the only one in my class at Temple University and at New Jersey Institute of Technology who actually decided, yes, I decided to study engineering. Very tough field, but you can make a lot of money. And the opportunities are numerous. You can own your own engineering firm. You do design. He studied nuclear engineering, which nuclear engineering is basically a break off of chemical and mechanical engineering, and you got a lot of thermodynamics involved. But he also has a knack for working green energy. As a civil engineer, I've always wanted to try taking wastewater and converting it into clean water. What he's doing, he's taking energy and converting it into solar, like coal energy, wants to convert it into solar energy. He's basically into the green type of energy, which you see a lot of that going on today. The problem with the green sector, it hasn't come on to be something that is highly recognized yet, because, you know, when you utilize solar energy, you have to depend on the sun, and wind energy, you have to depend on the wind. I live here in Portage, Indiana, and if you go down 65 toward Purdue University, you're going to find a wind farm, and what happens is you get the air, it turns the blade of the windmill, and or we call it the turbine, and that turbine emits current, and that's where electricity is basically generated. Hydroelectric power is not green energy, but that's another form of electricity that's generated, again, by water turning the turbine and emitting current through the electrical wires, and you have these what we call high voltage towers or overhead power lines. They go to a substation, and from a substation, the power gets distributed amongst the whole city. But with green energy that he was talking about as an engineer, green energy is very, 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 very clean. Now, I am happy for this gentleman that he was inducted into the Hall of Fame, because the previous inventors that I did, they only got their respect when they were dead and gone. When you deal with any type of energy or any engineering as a black person, a lot of us don't go into engineering because it's a very difficult field. Now, what I liked about Mr. Johnson, he went to the Air Force, and he worked with NASA. My dad also worked at NASA as well. And he may have worked at NASA when my dad worked at NASA, because my dad's an electrical engineer. But the first quarter of business, when you invent something, you're going to test it. It's not always going to work. But you have to keep on trying. This is what makes a person successful and non-successful. See, people who are successful have ambition. They're going to keep trying, and eventually you're going to succeed. Remember this, you only have to break through one time. But if you never try it, how do you know it's going to work? Let me tell you something about failure that we don't understand. Because Mr. Johnson had a couple of experiments that failed. Failure can be successful. Here's why. Because you can find out what happened. It's called an after-action report or after-action assessment. Because once you understand what happened, guess what? You got two things you can do. You go back, you start the project all over again, but you tweak it a little bit. And once you tweak it, then you test it again, or you scrap it and you start something new. The bottom line is you must be the brains behind the invention, or be the architect behind the invention. And if you look at what he has done, again, he's only 67 years old. He's going to be 68. So he's still around, where, of course, the other inventors, they didn't have the same technology that Lonnie G. Johnson had. They had basically taken something, utilized wood and other materials that they can find to create something. Their material had to be improved over and over and over and over again. Now, Lonnie G. Johnson, he continues to do work. And that's a good thing, because I'm doing this, gentleman, because I want to see more African Americans go into STEM. STEM stands for science, technology, engineering, and math. A number of us, when we go to school, we have no idea the opportunities that STEM can provide. I mean, you can go into computers, engineering, technology, science. That's where the big money is. It's not over here in these social fields. Yes, you'll get a good government job, but where the rubber meets the road, you got to go STEM. This is why I urge black men and women to be strong in math. I mean, engineering has less than 1% African Americans. That number needs to come up. And then we could go ahead and be a force by developing our own products for us. You see, what Lonnie Johnson has done, he's got his face in the mainstream with the government. They all know him. He's with the Air Force. He was with NASA, and he continues to do research and commitment. This is what engineering takes. Somebody that is going to make sacrifices. And I will tell you about the curriculum of engineering. Very difficult. I mean, if you do not get past algebra or trigonometry, stick a fork in it. You're not going to make it in engineering. Because everything builds off of those courses, even calculus and differential equations. And you have other courses that you must contend with, like thermodynamics, AC-DC circuits, statics, dynamics, and mechanics of materials. You must go utilize physics, all calculus-based physics. Now you could go the other way and go to the engineering technology, which is basically the same, except engineering technology is more applied, where engineering utilizes more of the theory. But either way, both areas of engineering and other forms of STEM are very demanding. This is why the STEM professors, when you get into that field, STEM is very, very difficult. But if you understand the concepts, it could be easy. but it takes a lot of studying and commitment. And to be a scientist and create different items that we're using today, that's an accomplishment, especially when you come up during the days of segregation. And this is why I tell all the younger generation folks out there that, hey, there were some people in the, particularly the baby boomer generation, because you had great people and you had bad people. You have to focus on both, because if you understand what happened during the baby boomer generation of the 60s, and that's when the civil rights movement took place, but you also look at some of the colleges like Maryland and Alabama, they started accepting more black people. Now, unfortunately, that did a job on the HBCUs, but the problem I have with a lot of the HBCUs is they don't have enough of them with engineering programs. I mean, you have Hampton, you have Norfolk State, Morgan State, Howard, FAMU, and there are some other ones out there, but most of the HBCUs that I can remember all had African-American studies, women's studies, English. They had those fields that, not saying that they're not beneficial, but when it comes to marketing and building opportunities for yourselves, you got to go STEM. I believe wholeheartedly in STEM, and I'm not trying to sound biased, but when you can get through a STEM program, you can get through any program. And if you're going to go STEM, go business after that, because once you develop something, then you get a business. And this is what Lonnie Johnson did. He went from being the engineer to his own boss. Again, it takes a lot of sacrifice and commitment. And if you have a spouse or a partner, they're going to have to be understanding of that, because when you begin to know yourself as a man or woman, and you have a supporting cast behind you, the stress is much less. And this is what we have to do as black people. And I would even say that on YouTube. You have YouTubers out here who put all types of content out, regardless of if you agree with it or disagree with it. Make sure that you support the content. Now, I don't do the same type of content that Angry Man does, or Obsidian, or O'Shea, or Ringo TV, but their content is very good. I do educational content, but we need all types of content. And I did like what Brother Obsidian said. Brothers, we got to stop beefing with each other on YouTube. And he made his apology, and my shout-outs go to Angry Man as well. He's doing good work, good talent. I'm proud of him. Proud of all black men and women who want to achieve success, because it is difficult out here. And for brothers, we didn't have that media who wanted to hear our griefs, but now we have it. Let's take the time to make use of it. But again, we got to support one another, regardless of the content. And I'm talking about content that you can learn from, not drama content. I'm about helping somebody by giving them the proper information to help them succeed. And that's what I tend to do. That's why I brought out Lonnie Johnson, because he is another influential African-American person who doesn't get much limelight because he's overlooked in the African-American community. Because, again, what we talk about in the African-American community is basically civil rights. I'm not going to talk too much about civil rights during Black History Month, because we've already been indoctrinated with that concept several times. And there'll be other YouTubers to do that. What I'm doing is simply talking about figures that you don't hear about. Just like when I get into the Underground Railroad, we know about it, but do you know what went into the Underground Railroad to make it successful? No, that's coming up in another video. But to stay on topic, when I read this article about Lonnie B. Johnson, it made me feel good about STEM, because we can do it. We just have to put our minds to it. And the problem with us as black people is we let the media and other conglomerates or elitists talk us down to keep us on a plantation. And the only way you get off that plantation is you got to keep trying. And you're going to be a threat to the establishment, no doubt. But you have to keep on your grind if you want to succeed. And Lonnie Johnson is his successor. And he's on his grind. And I want everybody to learn from this individual. And consider, if you go to college, try the STEM programs out. If you don't like STEM, go into computers. But science, technology, engineering, and math, if you want inventions, the STEM program is where you're going to find it. And once you find an outlet or a niche, then you go ahead and start a business. Because business is very important as well. But at the end of the day, if you want to hunt an understanding, you want to have an understanding of the state of engineering by African-American men. In fact, I had a frat brother by the name of Steve Johnson. If anybody is familiar with NSBE, the National Society of Black Engineers, which I am a part of, well, he founded that. And I'm a member of Phi Eta Psi fraternity, and a lot of people don't even know what that fraternity is. And what I want to tell you all, just because something doesn't exist at the surface doesn't mean it's non-existent. There's a world of information out there. But just like a job, you got to get it. It's not going to come to you. So at the end of the day, if you are looking for a role model who is successful in science, technology, engineering, and math, you must go with Mr. Lonnie G. Johnson. And I also want you all to like this video, because if you listen to all the words that I am putting out in my presentation, you will be able to succeed in not only STEM, but any other field that is interest to you. Because in a black community, we need to talk about more success instead of degression. Because there are some heavy hitters out here in the African-American field. And I'm just pointing them out with all of my YouTube videos. And I'm not going to just be doing these men and women during Black History Month. I'm going to do it after Black History Month, because we need to know that these men and women are part of our African-American history. And that's my commentary for this edition of the 401 Talk Zone Radio Show for this evening, Monday, February 20th, 2017. Tune in to the 401 Talk Zone Radio Show every Monday from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. on Blog Talk Radio. Guest call-in number is 215-383-5785. And if you like my videos, please share and subscribe to the 401 Talk Zone Radio Show right here on YouTube, so I can continue to give you quality information for educational purposes from a professional and mature perspective. Now, on this channel, I don't engage in debates, controversial issues, or emotional issues, nor do I participate in drama or unnecessary bickering. What I do is give you the information to educate you so you can have the tools in order to meet the challenges of the real world. So I keep everything realistic but positive. And if you have a channel, a business, or a topic that you would like for me to discuss on YouTube or Blog Talk Radio, please email me at lej6521@gmail.com. And if you'd like to comment, leave it in the comment section under the video. But make sure that your comments are pithy. No bloviating, pettifogging, or filibustering. If you wish to opine, time for some shout-outs. Shout-out to Conscience Effort. There's another one, Brother Tobias. Thank you for coming on board. Brother Rashawn DeLay. Sister Karen Kennedy. Sani Poo. Reg the Bad Guy. The Real Deal from Gary, Indiana. Brother Matt Coley. Brother Warren Williams. Brother Devlon Chapman. Brother Q Wilson. The Healing Palace. Mrs. G's Cooking Show Green. And that's it for this video. Till next time, my name is Leon Jones. Remember, please be gentle and respectful to each other, and have a wonderful and blessed night. Good night.